the Lamb. Glory to the Lamb. Glory to the Lamb. Glory to the Lamb. Hello there, and thank you for tuning on to another episode of our Scripture Breakdown Ministry. My name is David Abraham, and our scripture for today comes from Jeremiah 1, verse 5. And it says, "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I sanctified you. I ordained you a prophet to the nations." I repeat, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I sanctified you. And I ordained you a prophet to the nations. Now, I want to divide this scripture into three parts. The first part says, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Now, originally, this scripture is God speaking to Jeremiah. So God was telling Jeremiah here, he said, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. This is deep. This speaks about essence. This speaks about purpose. This speaks about destiny. This speaks about showing that everybody that was born has a purpose. Everybody has a meaning. Everybody has a reason why they came onto the face of this earth. So he said, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. So God knew him, knew the number of hair on his head. God knew his name. God knew the blood type, the blood group. God knew his skin color. God knew his train of thoughts. God knew if he would be a prophet, if he would be an evangelist. God knew if he would be a scientist. God knew if he would be a deliverer. So God knew him. He said, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. That means before essence, before there was a spark of light in his genes, in his being, in his spirit, before the candle of his spirit was lit up, God said he knew him. He knew who Jeremiah was. He knew who his name was. He knew his lineage. He knew who he was going to come from. He knew where he was going. He knew where he had set him to go. He knew what the vision he was going to give to him is. So what God is trying to say now here is that everybody has a purpose. Everybody has a meaning. Everybody has a reason. Everybody has their mission. Everybody is given a vision. Everybody has passions, all which are imputed into one by the same God. Then the second bit said, before you were born, I sanctified you. This could be specific to Jeremiah. It said, before you were born, I sanctified you. Now, before he was born, we know before he was formed in the womb, before he was given a natural birth. He said, I sanctified you. What is sanctification? Sanctification is setting apart, declaring as holy. Is sanctification is creating. Sanctification is making special. So God is telling Jeremiah that he sanctified him. He made him clean. He made him pure. He made him holy. Before he knew him, he set him apart as special for a particular purpose, for a reason, for a mission, for a vision, for the will of God, for the will of God to be fulfilled. Then the third bit said, I ordain you a prophet to the nation. So here is the main thing, that why he said he sanctified him, why he said he knew him, because he wanted him to be one of his prophets, one of the prophets of old, one of the great prophets of the Bible, one of the prophets whose name would linger forever and ever, one of the prophets who has posterity attached to his name, one of the prophets who came from the root of Jacob, one of the prophets who he set apart to serve as an everlasting example unto the generations of Jews and Gentiles, or better still, the generation of Christians to come. So he said, I ordained you a prophet to the nations. So he had been given a ranking as a prophet. He had been given an authority as a prophet, the spiritual authority. He has been given an office as a prophet right from the womb. So at any point in time, he decided to resume his prophetic office was left to the way he paddled on the journey, was left to the way he went about the journey, was left on the way he realized himself and realized that gift in him of being the gift of visionary, the gift of prophecy, which he ought to have realized while he was on the face of this earth. Some people realize whilst they are young, some people realize when they are older, but ultimately realization is very important to the fulfillment of God's will in one's life, to the fulfillment of God's will in one's life, to the fulfillment of God's dreams and vision in one's life, and the influence of the environment as God has proposed it, as God has ordained it to be. Now, I want to pray that God is able to expand our minds and our hearts whilst knowing that God knows our every move. God knows where we're going. God knows where we're coming. God knew us before we were born. And therefore, every mission and vision and passions which we have are being instilled in our lives by God, especially if they are things that glorify Him. I want to pray that God is able to help us realize ourselves, that we might know what we are on the purpose, our purpose on the earth, that we might realize and come to actualization what God wants us to do, that we may continually please God and live in His will. All this I ask through Jesus Christ our Lord. Now, for questions and for comments, you can email me on thetubeministry@gmail.com. That is thetubeministry@gmail.com. I thank you so much for listening, and God bless. God bless. In Jesus' name, amen.